Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
Welcome to the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Special Edition. Hill here, bringing you a new series. And it's been a long time coming. I tried playing this game 5 years ago when it first came out on the Xbox 360. And I didn't like it, and I never finished it. I really didn't get far into the game at all. I was getting lost. I was turned into a vampire. Everything bad that you could imagine that would happen, happened to me. So I just quit. I gave up. Couldn't do it. But since then, I've played other RPG games. Dragon Age Origins, Dragon Age 2, Dragon Age Inquisition, Dragon's Dogma, and The Elder Scrolls Online, which I really loved despite the poor reception that it got from other gamers. I thought the combat in that game was really dynamic and fun. So I'm here to give Elder Scrolls V Skyrim another chance. Now that I've had experience playing these type of games, because when I played it the first time, I had no idea what I was doing. It was my first RPG, first sword and sorcery game, and it just didn't go well, folks. Just did not go well at all. But all right, we are here, back on the PC. And I tell you, this I love playing games on the PC because you can customize them any way you want to. And I have done just that. We have 103 mods that have been installed. So we are going to have a blast with this game. All right, let's see. Oh, I do want to mention the mods will be listed in the description down below. Due to space limitations, though, I was only able to put the name of the mod and the mod author. I was not able to include the links. But if you see any mods that you are interested in, want to know more about, want the links to, just leave me a comment in the comments field there, and I will go ahead and post the link to whatever mod or mods that you're interested in. So, I think that is about it. Before we begin here, well, I was going to show you, well, we're going to be playing this on the Adept difficulty, which is the normal mode in this game. Nothing too easy, nothing too hard. I think we've covered everything. Let's get started. And again, here we go. It's warning me that mods are currently loaded. And I have crafted a backstory around these mods, because some of these mods are cheat mods, but there is a backstory that goes with these cheats that helps explain everything. So it doesn't, I mean, I'm not just going to completely cheat and be overpowered, but I am going to have some powers. All right, and more powers than what you normally see in Skyrim. Let's go. Now, we may have an issue with one mod. I'm not sure what it is that causes this, but in the opening scene where we're on the carriage with the horse, let's see what happens. It's like sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I've had to play through this many, many times trying to get this fixed and the mods, you know, in the right order. But let's see what happens this time. Kind of nervous, but, you know, maybe it's going to work for you guys. Would be nice. But that seems to be the only issue, the only mod that I'm having trouble with. So as you can see, Cheat Room has been installed. And, you know, it will allow me to give my character all kinds of abilities and powers. But, you know, I'm not going to use them all, just some. All right, and you can see the other mods. Some of them are loading there in the upper left-hand corner. So let's get moving here. Uh-oh, I think it's working right this time. Ah, okay. Well, that's good and bad, because it was kind of funny the way this was working. It's like the wheels on the cart were coming off, the horse was off to the right. I mean, it was all kind of craziness. The cart was almost flipping over, but now it's working. It's amazing. But what I did, there is a mod I installed called Better Horses, and it makes the horses move faster and whatnot. And I think that's what was causing the problem. The horse was going too fast for the cart. So that's disabled for the moment as we get through this entry scene here. And I'm glad to see it's working.
Trying to cross the border, right? Walk right into that Imperial ambush. Same as us. And that thief over there.
Damn you Stormcloaks. Skyrim was fine until you came along. Empire was nice and lazy. But they hadn't been looking for you. You'd stolen that horse and been halfway to Hammerfell. You there. You and me. We shouldn't be here. It's these Stormcloaks the Empire wants.
We're all brothers and sisters in vines now, thief.
Shut up back there.
What's wrong with him, huh?
Watch your tongue. You're speaking to Ulfric Stormcloak, the true High King.
Ulfric? The Jarl of Windhelm?
You see they've gagged him.
They captured you. Oh gods, where are they taking us?
I don't know where we're going, but Sovereign Guard awaits.
No, this can't be happening. This isn't happening.
Hey, what village are you from, horse thief?
Why do you care?
A Nord's last thoughts should be of home.
Rorikstead. I'm from Rorikstead.
Alright, so we've come out of the fog. And when I first played this game without any of the mods and stuff, I looked at it and said, oh my god, this looks like a 5-year-old game with a new coat of paint. It really didn't look much better than the original, except for all this fog and smog and whatnot, which I really don't like. But, I mean, I think the game now that I've added the mods and stuff, I mean, I don't know if you guys could really tell, I can, but it looks pretty incredible for a game that's been around for 5 years. So I'm really pleased, and mod authors, I can't thank you guys enough. I mean, you really make a gamer's experience incredible, and I thank you all. I want to give you all the credit that you're due. I want people to discover you, support you. You know, I just wish you guys all the best. Thank you so much for making my game so much better.
Kinnereth, Akatosh, Divines, please help me.
Look at him. General Tully is the military governor. And it looks like the Dalmor are with him. Damn elves.
Guess that's Tullius over there in the red cloak, I think. Wow, this is so great that the horse cart is stable. You guys, you should have seen the way this thing was bouncing around.
I used to be sweet on a girl. Wonder if Velod is still making that mead with juniper berries mixed in. Funny, when I was a boy, Imperial walls and towers used to make me feel so safe.
So apparently, and you know, I'm still learning about this game, this Ulfric Stormcloak here, I believe he has a dragon shout. That's why they've had to gag him, because he can actually kill people with his voice. Kind of like a Black Bolt of the Inhumans.
Why do you think? End of the line. Let's go. Shouldn't keep the gods waiting for us.
No, wait! We're not rebels!
Face your death with some courage, thief.
You've got to tell them. We weren't with you. This is a mistake.
Step towards the block when we call your name. One at a time.
Empire loves their damn lists.
And these people over here on the left were all invisible due to some mod issues I was having earlier, which have been fixed. Yay!
Care of Rorikstead.
No, I'm not a rebel. You can't do this.
Halt!
You're not gonna kill me.
Archers! Anyone
else? I think they just killed him.
Wait, you there? Step forward.
Who are you?
All right, now it's customization time. I may speed this up. We'll see what happens in post-production, but we are going to be playing a Redguard. All right, and here is our character. We will name him. Sundar.
What are you doing here, Redguard? You a sellsword? A sailor from Strosmikai? Captain, what should we do? He's not on the list.
Forget the list. He goes to the block.
By your orders, Captain.
Bitch, you just want to kill me because I'm black.
Remains or turn to Hammerford. Follow the captain, prisoner.
You know what? If anything happens to me, I will come back from the dead and make sure you pay.
Frick Stormcloak. Some here in Helgen call you a hero, but a hero doesn't use a power like the voice to murder his king and usurp his throne. You started this war, plunged Skyrim into chaos, and now the Empire is going to put you down and restore the peace.
What was that?
It's nothing. Carry on.
Yes, General Tullius. Give them their last rites.
As we commend your souls to Aetherius, blessings of the eight divines upon...
For the love of Talos, shut up and let's get this over with.
As you wish.
Come on! I haven't got all morning. My ancestors are smiling at me, Imperials. And you say the same.
Oh, shit. Tall Papa, chief deity of the Yakudin pantheon, I ask for your mercy.
As fearless in
protect
death
me
as he was in life.
Next, the Red Guard.
Here it is again. Did you hear that?
I said, next, prisoner.
To the block, prisoner. Nice and easy.
Y'all don't want to do this. Y'all don't want to do it. Chopping my head off would be a mistake, and you could at least clean up this mess here from the last person you killed.
What in oblivion is that?
Sentry.
Nah, Tall Papa. You answered my prayers. Everybody dead. Where are you taking me? I can't even see.
Could the legends be true?
Legends don't burn down villages.
Am My eyes are cleared up now.
Up through the tower. Let's go.
Alright, I'm following you.
Let's go.
My hands are tied. I can't do nothing.
Let's go.
Oh shit, what the? What? Look out! My hands are tied. Can't you cut my hands loose? Motherfuck you. Gotta do this the hard way. Jesus. Yeah, get that boy over here.
Still alive, prisoner? Keep close to me if you want to stay that way. Gunnar, take care of the boy. I have to find General Tullius and join the defense.
God's guide you, Hadbar.
Alright, let's go. Can't you untie my hands? Motherfuck, what the?
Stay close to the wall!
Oh shit, what the dragon wing right here?
Quickly, follow me!
You gotta be kidding me. Tall Papa, you supposed to be protecting me.
It's you and me, prisoner. Stay close.
Cut my hands loose. I could pick up a bow. Mother. You know what? Y'all gonna pay for this. Y'all gonna pay. Kidnapped me, beat me, tied me up. Y'all gonna pay. I'm going with this dude here. This dude went in a cart with me. Alright, let's go. If I trust you now, you could have cut him off earlier.
Let's cut you loose. Come on, you need your hands free. Those vines aren't going to cut themselves. Let's cut you loose. As well take Gunyar's gear. He won't be needing it anymore. Grab Gunyar's gear. Nope.
Alright, folks. So here we are. And I'm going to give you the backstory of this character here real quick. Alright, so it all began with Ruptga, the chief deity of the Yakudan pantheon. Commonly known as Tall Papa. It could have been a whim, plain boredom, or foreknowledge of the Dragonborn when he placed a small portion of his godlike essence into a Redguard male. The transformation was instantaneous, giving the Redguard enhanced health, stamina, and magicka. The joining also gave him the ability to call upon the power of any godlike being through conjuration, enchantment, and teleportation. Though not trained as a mage, he found using his powers and abilities natural and innate. As wondrous as his powers were, he decided to suppress them and chose to live life as a normal Redguard warrior and sellsword. It wasn't until he was captured, humiliated, beaten by the Imperials, and taken to Helgen, that he reconsidered his station in life and the use of his powers. Contemplating the complete embrace of godhood while fighting to maintain his humanity, Sundaar the Redguard walks a dangerous path in the lands of Skyrim. Okay, enough of the melodrama here. Alright, so we're looting this guy's corpse, and here's the first of our cheat items here, the Earring of Unburden. And this is going to increase my carrying capacity, so I will take this. And I will also take this cuirass, boots, and war axe. So let me put these on real quick. Cuirass, boots. Hold on, let me get the axe. Okay, and let me favorite this. Okay.
See if I can find some way out of here. Ah, this one's locked. Let's see about that gate.
Oh, magic chest. I think this is another of the cheat mods. I don't remember installing this, but anyhow, necklace of super crafting. Created potions are 1,000 times more powerful, and items are enchanted 1,000 times stronger. Insane. Now, I may not use these folks, but you know, at least they're here. And we also have the necklace of super crafting, and same thing. So we'll take these. Oh shoot, here come some guards. Damn, I can't hit a damn thing. Okay, there we go. Okay, we need that. I guess I'm gonna take this armor. I can sell it. I wonder if this sword is any better. Warax is 9, sword is 9. I'm gonna go with the sword. Alright,
unlock that door. Let's get out of here.
Now you need to wait. What's his name? Rayloff. Because I think we got some more stuff in here. Yeah, here's another one of these chests that have been installed. And I am going to go ahead and... Oh, that's a lot of stuff here.
here's a bow. Look at this. Soul gems. Gold. Key. Not sure what this is. Killing before you're killed. 20 lockpicks. 5 potions of healing. And look at these spell tomes. Bound sword? Really? Familiar? Courage, flames, frostbite, fury, healing. Healing hands, raise zombies. I don't know what that is. Some torches. Magicka poison. Am I run out of no, not yet. And okay, we've got amulets now. Amulet of Zenithar. This is better prices. Restoration spells are less. Block damage is better. Speech. Increase health. Magicka. Stamina. Magic regenerates faster. Time shouts reduced by 100%. How much is this sword? Because I think I've got 3 of them now. I don't think I need any more. I don't think we need that. Since I'm not a mage, not going to take any of those robes. I think we're fine here, but I need to equip some of this stuff. And go ahead, Sundar.
Thank you, Tall Papa. Thank you for your blessings. I know this chest was a gift from you.
All right. Let's see, we need to favorite this bow. And this is one thing I don't like about this game, is that shields are apparel and not weapons. That makes no sense to me. So is this one? Which one is the better one? Imperial Light Shield 21, that's 22. I think I want to, can I put this, how do I put this on equip? I need to put on this earring. This is what's going to increase my carry weight. And this is all because of the power of Tall Papa. So I tried to make his backstory as lore friendly as possible. Oh, man. You know, I keep skipping over the shield, I'm sure. Come on, I guess I'm just going to take a daggone shield, but there was the round one, the round metal one. Where is it? Is it up here? Alright, well, anyhow, we can put on these amulets. Another ability that he has is the ability to wear unlimited amulets. So, he can wear them all. Here it is. Let's favorite this. All right. I think we're ready. Let's see, are there any potions over here? No. Got some wine, but there's no time for drinking. Oh, there's another chest. Empty, okay. Some gold. We can take that. Just sell these things. Okay, well, that should be all of the cheat items that we have installed at this part of the game. Go ahead and unlock this door.
That's it. Come on, let's get out of here before the dragon brings the whole tower down on our heads.
See, we got another door over here.
Dragon doesn't give up easy. Grab everything important and let's move. Dragon's burning everything to the ground.
Somebody in here.
I just need to gather some more potions.
Y'all friends or foe? Should have known better. Alright.
See if you can find any potions. We'll need them.
I'm gonna leave the food alone for now.
Done. Let's get moving.
No, some people, I think this is new in Skyrim SE that you can actually take the torturer's hood. I don't know why you would want to.
Wait a second. Looks like there's something in this cage. It's locked. See if you can get it open with some picks. We might need that gold once we get out.
Alright, stand aside.
Anything useful, then let's go.
I got this.
And I have a mod installed, easy lock picking. Simple. Because I don't like to waste my time trying to figure out, you know, how to pick locks and do stuff that prevents you from enjoying the game. So let's just get it on, let's get it over with, let's go on our adventure. While we're here, let's pick all of these locks so my lock picking skill may actually go up. Nothing in there. That mace is like 1 point damage better than the sword. I'm just gonna keep the sword. Yeah, I'm having a time with this sword though, because the reach is not very long. Okay, read the book of Dragonborn. Alright, I guess we'll read that later on. Oh, can I take it? I can't take it. Alright, I think we're done here. Thanks for waiting. Got some more locks to pick. Oh, look at that. Lock picking increased. coin purse. We'll take that. Wait, what is this? Search skeleton? Ooh, some more gold. Alright, so bone meal I can eat. And this is how you discover ingredients and stuff when for alchemy, I think. Okay. Dude. More gold. Okay, let's go. Think these people don't want to talk, huh?
Orders are to wait until General Tullius arrives.
I'm not waiting.
Oh, heck. Oh, look, he's gonna put up his fist. Really? All right, we got him. Now, that's one thing you should absolutely never do is bring fists to a sword fight. Was there somebody else down here? Guess we've looted enough. Wait, who was this here? Plenty of arrows.
Looks like a wreck. Let's see where this goes.
What a NPC that can actually do something? You know, some of you game makers might need to take note of what Bethesda's doing here. It's like, I don't have to do everything. Alright, before we go any further, don't I have a bunch of, like, spell tomes and stuff? Not sure where that... Is it under books? Yeah. Okay, so this kind of tells you how to fight. That's nice. Alright, bound sword. It's probably kind of early to learn that. Courage, what does this do? Targets won't flee? Why would I? Okay. Alright, flames. I know flames. Okay, frostbite. Fury. Alright, I know healing. What's healing hands? Okay, raise zombie. Sparks. Alright, I think we're good. But this character is not a mage, although we will probably be exploring some magic later on, since he is just going to be very powerful. Okay, got some more gold.
That doesn't go anywhere. Guess we better try this way.
I'm not liking the way this looks. The hell is that? Killed it in one hit. Is that it? Oh! Hmm. Wow, this tutorial is quite easy. Now, I don't have any kind of augments. Well, nothing that would kill anything easy. I mean, my damage is not increased. I think I might have 10 added to my health and stamina and magicka, but that's not going to take these people down. Maybe it's this bow. A little more powerful than the entry-level bow. But Rayloff took these guys down, you know, some of them looks like with one swing of his sword. And I haven't done anything special to him.
Hold up! There's a bear just ahead. See her? I'd rather not tangle with her right now.
This person can't be pickpocketed.
And watch where you step.
Or if you're feeling lucky, you can take this bow. Might take her by surprise.
Oh, you automatically get a longbow. Oh, look, it woke up.
Sneaking is overrated, eh?
Don't walk in front of me, Rayloff. Did we get it? Is it dead? Yes. Oh wait, what is this? I can eat this? Eat some bear claws? Guess we'll take some the pelt.
There he goes. Looks like he's gone for good this time. No way to know if anyone else made it out alive. But this place is going to be swarming with Imperials soon enough. Better clear out of here. My sister, Gerda, runs the mill in Riverwood, just up the road. I'm sure she'd help you out. It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
Well, maybe it's not best that we split up.
You know, you should go to Windhelm and join the fight to free Skyrim. You've seen the true face of the Empire here today. If anyone will know what the coming of the dragon means, it's over.
Look at this, signs. Yeah, I was given some advice that I should try reading the signs, because, you know, when I played this game the first time, I ended up just wandering around in a figure eight in the woods, totally lost. So we got Riverwood going this way. Oh, did he leave me? Okay, well. Guess that's all right. But I think these mods have really done a great job with this game, because it did not look this good, you know, just out of the box. I mean, the reflections in the water, the clouds, I mean, the trees, I think they need a little bit more detail, but I like it. I like the way this looks. All right, we're here. These guardian stones can give us certain abilities. Thief stone. Under the sign of the thief, you will learn all stealth skills 20% faster, and you can only have one blessing at a time, so that's thief. This is mage stone. If you were a mage, under those under the sign of the mage will learn all magic skills 20% faster. And then we have the warrior stone, and this is a warrior, so we're going to accept this one. So he gets his warrior skills at 20% faster rate. Okay. Look at that. It's amazing. So this guy just left me. Uh-oh. They see me. Look at this. All right, that's not gonna work. Okay, wrap my one-handed up. I don't know, do we really need wolf pelts? We just leave them. Wait, maybe sometimes these wolves, they swallow gold. Take my arrow back. So, you know, you need to check their corpses for gold and other things they may have eaten. I know this was just a tutorial, but I really enjoyed this. I mean, now that I understand what these type of games are about, this has been fun. But I know it's going to get a lot harder from here. All right, we have discovered Riverwood. And there's Rayloff. He just went on up ahead of me. Okay, well, unfortunately, because this is YouTube, and file sizes are such as they are, and time limits are such as they are, I'm going to go ahead and end the video here, and we will return in the next episode and see what Sundaar is up to. But I thank you all for watching, and I will catch you later.